open session. Again, it's a pleasure to introduce my old friend, excellent groove theorist, Professor Xiaofei Du from Capital Normal University, Beijing. What to say about Xiaofei? Well, he finished his education, I think, at the same university, right? Beijing University, under supervision by Professor Miao Shu, who is a recognized expert in the theory of P groups. And actually, Miao Shu is now retired, but he developed a large group of excellent group theories in China. And Xiaofei is one of the best representatives of the Miao Shu school. But what is important to add is that Xiaofei is not just interested in the theory of groups as a theory of abstract groups, but he also likes to see groups as groups of automorphisms of combinatorial objects, in particular of graphs and maps, and he proved many interesting results in this direction. Okay, go on.
Okay, thanks to Roman for introduce. Thanks to Linda, Sasha, giving me this opportunity. I'm very happy to meet my old friend here. This year is exactly 20 years I got PhD since 1996. I remember in the May of 1996, I met Sasha Ivanov in some conference, speaking research conference. And in September, I went to Slovenia, worked with Dragan. There, meet Dragan, Sandy, Roman, and Boya. Then in the come to Mac, meet Professor Quark, Elena, Roman, and Sasha, my friend. At the beginning, I just worked with transient graph. When I was in Korea, before Roman come to Mac, I read some book, some paper about 2 months, regular Mac. Then we have joint work with Roman, Jim Paul, and Gary Jones and Scovia. This talk, I try to talk about two abstraction cover. My friend here working the regular cover. But in my point, I want to concentrate on the relationship between cover and group theory. This work is a joint work with Professor Bob Ming Yao, Dragon, my student, Mr. Xu, and also my supervisor, Professor Xu. There are 6 sections. First, I want to record some definition about the regular current graphs. And section 1, I want to introduce some background of how to classify 2 arbitrary graphs. And the third one is the main part, to talk about the 2 arbitrary covers. And in the fourth one, I want to say something about the relationship between topological latent theory and group extension theories. And give some examples and say something about further research. Okay. This is standard definition. What is the covering from X to Y means you have a surjective P, Vx to Vy. If X is mapped to Y, then the neighbor of X to the neighbor of Y is a bijection. A local is bijection. This standard definition for covering. So we call the X as current graph, Y is a basic graph. Okay, for each V, it's a perm image is called the vertex fiber. Here, edge is edge head fiber. So, the group of atom for preserving, this G is a, the G I call is a group of fiber preserving groups. What means current transformation group K? That means the kernel of G acting the fibers. So, map fiber to fiber. So when X is connected, it's easy to see this K acts semi-regular on each fiber, means no fixed point K. In a particular case, if k acts regularly on the fiber, then we call it the regular covers. In this case, k is a normal subgroup of g, so g mod k is a subgroup of the out of y. This is a standard example. This graph Q3 to K4 is a 2A, A1, A2, 2A, B1, B2, to B, and so on. So you see, the neighbor of A1 is C1, B1, C1, B2, B2, C2. The neighbor of A also C3 point. Locally, it's a bijective, 3 to 3. This is an important picture for the current. The subgraph between two fiber is a perfect matches. These are important pictures for this. Okay, this is one of standard examples. Okay, we take a bipartite graph V, two part. U is just a non-zero vector, non-zero vectors. This W is a hyperplane of a fine geometry. We take the alpha is the maximum subspace. Take all of these. Then you take the if V, then it's joined with the U W alpha, the U plus alpha, if and only if V belong to this hyperplane. Okay, with the bottom, Y is a non-existent graph of point and hyperplane in the projected geometry. Okay, we define the projection P like this. V, K, V, and Q minus V map this to this point. This hyperplane to just this alpha. Then you will see if P belongs here, then K, V belongs here, then this is a matching. You will see the X is a Q minus Y for the cover of Y. Okay, next I talk about the vertex graph and the derived graph. This is definition. Given graph Y and a group K, finite group usually, we have function F from arc set of Y to K. For each arc UV, FUV is the FVU minus. To reverse arc, it gives the reverse element. So for this Y, this F, we call this a vertex graph. From vertex assignment, you can define the big graph, the derived graph. So the vertex side like this. And for each arc UV, each element T, UG adjoint VT, here is the vertex on the arc VU. This is arc set. So this is a derived graph. From the definition, you see, here is the bottom, in the bottom, VU, UV. The K is the vertex on the VU. Okay, this is fiber over V, is over fiber of V. U1 joint is the VK, K is the vertex. Okay, and UG joint UKG. So you got the dimension, from definition, we can see that for if you map this UK, any K to U, is the given current from the derived graph to the Y, whose current transformation group is an isomorphic to K, is K. And each regular curve can be derived by the vertex assignment F. Next definition is left. So, given alpha in the basic graph, bottom of basic graph, if you have alpha bar in the current graph, satisfy this condition, alpha bar P equal to PR, then we set this alpha left to some alpha bar. General question like this. Given graph Y, a group K, and a subgroup of auto Y, find all of connect regular color on which is H left. How to choose H depends on the property of what you want to have. So F left to G, then G modular K isomorphic to H. So we can say the left problem is actually the group expectation problem, 1 key, 2 key to H, is the standard notations. Well, this is a latent theorem from topological graph theory. Given this current, for any alpha, alpha lives if only if for any closed work in the Y, for is if Y the voltage on Y is the trivial, then alpha met W this voltage also trivial. If you have this condition, this alpha can be left. Theoretically, this is a very nice theorem. But it's, when you use it to solve some problem, it's difficult to use, depends on the graph you choose. This is standard theorem. I just am used to quite from the Sundays when people. In a special case, if K is abelian group, then we have some in the abelian case, we have some theorem. It's easy to use. Okay, in the case of abelian, alpha, if alpha left to alpha bar, centralized K, then the voltage on this R, W, and W alpha is the same. The condition is strong, but the result is much stronger than the general theorem. You see, here is the if this is one and this is also one, but here it's the same, but you have more strong condition. Here is abelian now. So the one of the important part is the element abelian. If K is element abelian group, then this actually is a matrix problem. In these two papers, they use a different method, give some general language, how to decide what the assignment. First of all, we use a matrix language. Here, someday they use another method. Different, both of them from the latent theorem. I will not give detail in here. But for general abelian group, not only any abelian group, Marston is a student. They gave some general method to how to construct the abelian cover. But anyway, both this abelian and anti-abelian, you can just determine the very small graph. You see that there's a QD graph and a Hilbert graph. They have small number of country arc. You can use this method. Generally, it's difficult. This is the first part. And the second part, I will talk about some background from the last 5 2 up 20 graphs. 2 up means it's UVW. VW is R, but U is not equal to W. If the auto X translated on 2 arcs, we call it 2 up translated graph X. Start from Smiley Bashir's second theory. In this paper, they give some theorem like this. For each finite connected 2 up translated graph is one of the following. First case, each non-trivial normal group, subgroup of auto X, X translated on Vx. So this case they call it quite a primitive type. The second type is each normal group has at most 2 orbit, but at least one has 2 orbit. This graph must be bipartite graph. General case is there are some normal group which has at least 3 orbits, then it must be covered of first 2 type. This is a Bayesian survey. This is a picture. This is a quasi-primitive part. This is bipartite. This is cover style. That's 3 type. This is easy to prove like this. You see, if you have three part, 3 infinite blocks. So you take if you this B, there are 2 neighbors here, more than 2 neighbors. You see, this is one up. A, B, C1 is two arc. A, B, C2, another two arc. You have element map this to this, means fix A, fix B, map C1 to C2. It's impossible because these are infinite blocks. So between these two blocks must match this color. For the first case, there are a lot of results. I tried to match many of the early results. Sasha and Gregor, they classify all of affine keys. That means the quasi primitive and the bipartite primitive in the affine case. Affine group acting that. This is a very good result. Also, another result, Chai Han Li, he determined all of vertex primitive and vertex biprimitive for ace arc, ace larger than 4. He gave all the list of this. There are also other people, and I didn't have a list here. For the bipartite type, Sharon also have a paper about the induction theory. I remember there are some people in here. But I here I want to talk about the cover. In the group sense, to classify two action graph, it induces the two directions. First is study quasi primitive and the bipartite type. That means you need to study finite simple group, almost simple group, and so on, to study the suborb structure related permutation repetitions. You need to give G, you need to determine all of these trip. That means study these things. For carrying, when you study carrying, you need to study the above group detection of above groups from the left or bottom. In many cases, it's related to central detection theory, sewer multiple theory, and the replacement theory, and so on. Okay, the third part is I concentrate on the two arc transit covers. We want to classify two arc transit covers by giving this graph. Two arc transit graph is two types. For example, complete graph, complete bipartite graph, and KNN. Also, you can give the color transformation group K, this element abelian or max second, and so on. Let's summarize that. Okay. First, we worked with the Dragon in 1996, classified the computer graph. The group is element abelian, but only small case, cyclic and case 2 in this paper. Later, we work on the case 3, but the case is much complicated than the first one. K is 4, still complicated, we didn't do that. It's a complete case. The second is about circular and dihedral. So the K graph on the cyclic group, dihedral group, we call it circular and dihedral. But if we want to classify all of such a graph, it's impossible, too complicated. So we concentrated on the two arc, give the condition for two arc transit group. For the circulant, this four friend they gave the classification for circulant. Just as very short paper, just three pages. They taught me at the beginning they use the classification, the very long. Finally, I use the combinatorial method, sorted, very short papers. But for the dihedral, it's very different. Actually, we started in 1996. In that time, we first gave the reduction theory, but we don't have so much knowledge about cover and stop that. So in 2003, Dragon gave this paper is just reduction theory. That means there are some of the primitive keys and the covers. But this paper finished classification for all of the covers. Anyway, this diagram was completed, classification. The third one is metacyclic. We try to try some of the non-abelian group, so we choose the metacyclic group. This is my student. You know, in China, you are the fourth student in the first name. how about this graph? This graph. We just try to let the cyclic piece and three-dimensional abelian group.
This is you remove the perfect matching or?
Sorry?
Here you remove perfect matching or?
Yeah.
K2 is then, right?
Oh, we have K2, yeah. We just published in the Slovenia channel, JG2. I don't know if it's published or not yet.
K2.
Yeah, we have published. After this, this graph is much complicated than the KN minus the mass matching. This graph. Yeah, it's also just some small group. Here is cyclic, here is the ZT2. It's just a sector in the Hungarian journal. Finally, some people work in the one up trader, not necessarily two up trader. This is more complicated. So it's just working in the KPT, not KNN, some Chinese model. That's some result. Okay, I might even talk about relationship. Relationship between topological latent theorem and group detection. This is the definition for some of these acoustic graph. Airborne and no death. Okay, this is some idea. I think that so for the cosine graph gives more information of groups because it is defined by groups. One step later, everything now in that. But for the latent theorem, vertex graph, in most of cases, can be used to determine the vertex graph from small piece of graph. Beaten graph, you have a small number of arcs. But for most of cases, use group extension can be determined a very big graph, repeated graph. What I say is so this latent and group survey, in some cases, if you combine these two methods together, you can get a very strange result. I want to say this. General idea from group theorem like to do this. If you try to classify cover with a given group K and some symmetric property like a star, first step, you need to find all the subgroups of H, ensuring this property star. You need to have classification for H. For each H, you need to determine the group extension measure. Then for each G, you determine the cosine graph. This is a general idea to use group theory. But we have three possibilities. First one is you have such a classification for H. Also, you can determine the group extension. This is the best case situation. But sometimes you have such a classification for H, but it is very complicated, sometimes almost impossible to determine the extension. Then you must set the slope. The worst case is you don't have such classification. How do we do? This is some new idea by joint latent theorem. I do that. So instead of using classification H, you pick up a subgroup H1. This H1 is easy to work on. That means you can easy to determine this group extension, G1, not G. Here, this H1 don't need to ensure stuff, just a subgroup. In some time, you can find all of the cosine graph from this G1. Then, from cosine graph, you construct the vertex graph, given the vertex assignment. Sometimes a very few graph can be obtained from here. Also, this assignment is a very nice, very simple. This is important things. For each x, now you already have x with vertex assignment. Then you choose a subgroup H2, which ensuring this stuff. Here you don't need to classification, just choose one. Because you already know all the graph in here. You find an H2. H2 you are bigger than H1. Then use latent theorem, show this S left, then you got all of graphs. This is some general idea. Now I give some examples. This is a latent theorem. This is a very easy example. So let K is 5 point computer graph. It's a vertical site. Here we take the vector space, add the root of vertical space, and find all of colors. This 5% group act too accentuated. This example solution like this. Okay, here is a current. This condition for P. So this is vertical assignment. For example, 2, 3 gives the group element. 0, 0, 1 belong here. This final result. The proof to ensure two accentuated, you must A5 must be left. That means these group extensions. Usually we can choose surviving tree. Then we have 6 Cauchy arc. We give the trivial object on the Cauchy on the tree arcs. Then you take a base. You take a base for 3-dimensional. Given the 3 Cauchy arc, we take all the possibility. Then other vertex on the armed Cauchy arcs. Usually is a linear combination for the base. Then you take some element of A5, use latent theorem to determine all the voltage on the Cauchy arcs. We observe that all the proof just depending on latent theorem because the graph is very small. We don't need some group extension theories. But this vertical assignment F is not simple, not nice. You see, it's complicated, not nice. This is a group. You see just the computation, not so many groups are inside. Let's keep it. Here I want to say, essentially it's a group extension problem, at least. Where is group theory and the reputation theory? Right. It's hiding the left theory. There must be some deep relation between group theory and the left theory. I want to find it. You see, this is another example. We can construct a vertex graph from an abstract group. First, you can determine this group detection, depends on what group of tools, and start the permutation representations, find the coset graph. From coset graph, we find the vertex assignment, then use latent theorem to show a subgroup, much bigger, can be left. Then finish all. I'll give you another example. You say, this is also a computer graph. The vertical side is a projected line. We still use this group, this current transformation group. And we try to find all of current such that this group left, not all, this group left. Then the group must be too accentuated. Solution. It's a final solution like this. This vertical assignment is very, very nice, very simple, you see. Because the vertical side is a particular line, 0, 1, something infinite. This arc, if it's j, take this, ij, take this. Very simple assignment. There are another family. Okay. The proof just give a very simple. So this group structure. We need to first determine this group. This group. We need to know the 3-dimensional representation for this almost simple group. There are some normal results about this. This is the representation from the PT error to the G error 3T. There are some results on this. Second step, you need to determine the point step later for the convex classes. Third step is determine the suborbit. This action points together. This step determines all of coset graph. Then from coset graph, we find the good vertical assignment. I already saw that nice assignment. Last step is for this P, we can extend to the any P-par, use latent theorem. You see how to use latent theorem. Okay, we give some generator for the PDR to P, 4 generator. Then you take any closer work, assume this is 0, trivial. Then you compute this is also trivial. So the left hand side is all generated left. So this group left. Third example, I want to say how to jump upstairs from the group theory. Sometimes we have some difficulty from the group analysis. Then we try to start from small group, try to find a nice quarter assignment. So left-hand theorem can be used. This is another example. Okay. This is a basic graph, K and N, a basic graph. Take this K is small, say T square, a small group. Still we're going to find all the cover with these two opportunity covers. Okay. This revised two part UW. Then this is the group, the very very big group, a very big group. Okay. This A is a two chance subgroup. Because this very big group, there are a lot of things about this A. You should consider all of A. We assume this A star is left of A, this G star. G star is fixed two part, fixed two part. From the two opportunity, this G is a two chance group on the two parts in this graph. Okay, we consider a special case. For example, we just consider the affine group. That means the action of G on two parts is an affine group, like this. It's a subgroup of this group. Because this group is quite big, there are a lot of subgroups in here. Now the point set, point is U, W can be identified as the vectors, vector. Then this is a P group of path, Okay, we went to this G, T, U, T, W means two P group path, with some H. H is a subgroup of this group, this group left. This sigma is a change to part, what is the group problem here is this expression, G modulus ZT square, isomorphic to this. This H is a subgroup of this, where H is a change on the non-zero vectors. This is a valid condition for H. But here, a lot of H. You are writing like this. You first time determine the P group. You see this expression. Determine the P part. Second, determine the this expression, two expressions. But even for this P part, it's quite difficult. Why? You see this. This is a meta-abelian P group. F here is one. It's just an extra special P group, we know this. For K larger than one, there is some non-result about classification in the P group. But they just gave the very rough like classification. Maybe 5 years ago, I asked Sasha and Elena to find some Russia paper from this Russia paper. But when I got it, it's still cannot use. It's not a Russian language problem. Just their classification, just a rough like classification. I cannot use it. Also, I need to give the class, study expression with another H inside. Okay, even we know this T group, then you need to know also such H. This H is a transitive on the non-zero vector. So we have classification. This is standard classification. Depends on finite simple classification. Sorry. So we don't know exactly classification of P, but if even we know, we need to determine for each case, determine the group extension. It's a terrible work, so it's too complicated. Finally, we found some general idea, like I just mentioned. How to do that? We choose a small group. What is a small group? Just this P group. Start from this P group. This is a TQ that is a lifting of P group. This concept later in the bigger graph. We only need to determine such parameters. We set these two metrics. Anyway, if you determine this, then you know that it is group. But how to do it for these two matrices? This is a final result. We can choose A is a Dedekind matrix, B like this, and A like this. So you see the word assignment, the very nice. You see that this for any alpha primer, two vertices in two part. The word assignment just like this, how to do that? First, I prove these two matrices is determined is not zero. Then we can choose the I is a Dedekind matrix. This is easy. Then we try to find quotation for the matrix B. Actually, we need to solve this equation, this matrix equation. Here, we write the term B, choose any matrix. From this equation, we need to know the B. How to do that? We just consider this sub-algebra from this. It's a cyclic algebra. Then we have this condition, this H number L. So we can prove the L is a field. Here, we don't use classification for H, we just use H as a transitive on the vertex space, and non-zero factors. Then we finish this error is clear. Okay, we can determine it's a B. Anyway, from here we already got the vertex assignment. Finally, how to do that? We choose another bigger group to use the left-hand theorem to show the left. Okay. Start from here, we already know this P group left, this two part left. Then from our list B, we choose a center leader, this in here. Then we got another group H, this rho P, something like that. Here is how to use left-hand theorem. If you give the first assignment, give the special group element, just check this. You must give a very nice word assignment, otherwise you cannot do that. Then we prove this left. Finally, we choose another Q, some fixed condition, we prove also use left theorem can be left. Then, finally, this group left. So far, we find all of cover. The proof is the bigger enough group can be left. This is a third example. Next example, I try to show some the application for the permutation model for construct covering. Yesterday, I found some paper that Shaka gave some problems, a solution for some permutation model. This is very useful in terms of current map. What is the permutation model? You start from transitive group on omega. You take x sub s with base omega. Then you have this g natural action on the basis. Then you got the representation of g. This is the character. So it's a theorem. There's some theorem, useful theorem in the this paper is not complete classification. Just give most two transitive group. The permutation model of two chain groups. This is some example. This is K8. This is I forgot to come in. Okay. I went to cite the further research. So, if you want to study algebra covers, this is standard representation. Sometimes not a split expectation. This T may be a simple group, a fan group, and so on, depending on what graph you choose. If you want to do more, if K is a bigger, any K, we have to understand more from the relative tools, such that classical group extension theory, symmetry extension theory, also T group. Most of the cases we use the ordinary model representation, permutation model, something like that. We need to know some new method for the any K, any K. Another topic I want to say is to use this method to study the regular method of covers. I know Gary Jones concept for the elementary abelian cover for platonic map, but just ordinary case, that means P not 2, 3, 5. Still, he worked on the T at 2, 3, 5. So there are not so much classification for the cover regular map. So maybe this is another topic for that. Okay, I should finish. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Are there any questions or comments? If not, then thank you.